Hello, everybody. This is Jason Lamb live on the NFHS Network from Great Bend, Kansas, and Barton Community College, the site of the Class 1A Division II State Championships. Good to be with you this afternoon across the state of Kansas and around the country as we begin this day with two consolation games. First up, the boys' third-place game between the Bucklin Red Aces and the Northern Valley Huskies. And let's take a look at the starting lineups. First of all, for the fourth-seeded Bucklin Red Aces, coached by Derek Bevin. Number zero, a 5'10 senior, is Nathan Bowman. At number 10, a 6'5 junior, Jaron Lindsay. Number 12, a 6-foot sophomore, Andrew Bowman. Number 15 is a 5'10 senior, Scott Price. And number 23, a 6'2 junior, Garen Stimpert. The Bucklin Red Aces, 19-6 on the season. And for the third seed, Northern Valley Huskies, coached by Kevin Sides in his third year, again in numerical order, beginning with a sophomore, number 11, Kenton Tallheim. A senior, number 15, Bailey Sides. Another senior, number 23, Eric Loya. A sophomore, number 24, Jeremiah Hansen. And rounding out the starting five for the Huskies is a junior, number 32, Foster Brands. Now, both of these teams came up short in last night's semifinal games. Bucklin bowed down to the number one seed, Hanover, 61-54. So Hanover's on into the state championship game. And it was Northern Valley falling to Greeley County, the Jackrabbits, 59-54 in a tight ball game. And here's the tip, and we are underway from the Kirkman Activity Center, Barton Community College. Third place in the state of Kansas on the line in the smallest classification of Sunflower State basketball. And right away we have a miss by Nathan Bowman and a turnover by Northern Valley. This is Bowman. He's the 5'10 senior. Price. Hesitation. And a foul. And the foul was called on Eric Loya. Loya is a senior. Inbounds pass. Deflected by Kenton Tauheim. And we'll do it again. This time they get it into Price. He puts it up, and it bounces off the front, the back, and off. And a near steal by Price. Price does it all for Bucklin, and he doesn't leave the floor. He's played in all 32 minutes of the quarterfinals and the semifinals. He's their leading scorer. Got a game-high 23 points, 5 assists, and 5 rebounds versus Caldwell in the quarterfinals on Wednesday. Northern Valley basketball. Hansen has it. They go inside. 31 misses it. Here's a drive. My bad, that was Brands, 32 with the miss on the other way a moment ago. All right, so we're going to get Bowman at the line with the fouls on sides. Bowman, averaging 11.7 per game. Swishes the first one. He had 5 points in both of the previous games here at the state tournament. 5 points, 5 assists versus Caldwell. 5 points in the semifinal loss to Hanover. Also had 6 assists last night. He has the first 2 points of this ballgame. Here's a three-pointer by Tauheim, and it's good. Kenton Tauheim. Price drives with the left, and it crawls in. He has all 4 for the Red Aces. Loose ball. Sides losing control. And he is called for traveling. Sides, the son of head coach Kevin Sides. And here's a blocking foul along the sideline. Charge on Loya, and I believe that's 2 quick ones on Loya. So he will come out of the ball game, and checking in now is Brady Preston. I apologize, Brody Preston. I can't read my own writing some days. The Red Aces flip it out to the corner. And they got it back out on top in the hands of Price. Price dribbles right, then left in the lane, and he stumbles, hits his head. And a foul is called. It's feeling like he lost his footing. But they got Tauheim on the foul. Red Aces basketball, and here's an open three. A good look. It skips off the rim. Rebound by the Red Aces, and another look at it. Price can't capitalize. Scooped up off the floor by Bowman. And the give to Price off the glass, and he made that one. It's 6-3. And here's a drive coast to coast by Sides. 6-5. And quickly the other way, the answer by Bowman. Andrew Bowman. There are 2 Bowmans. Number 0, Nathan, is a senior. Andrew is a sophomore.
Sides. Dribble accreditation. Bounces it. 1 dribble.
And a bucket by
Sides.
And we're going back and forth now as Garen Stempert stops and makes it short shot. Andrew Bowman challenges that pass, and it goes off the hands of Northern Valley, so it's Bucklin basketball. Bucklin with a 10-7 lead. Bowman to his brother. Cook underneath the basket. And a frustration situation there for Jaron Lindsay. He's not able to convert. Here's a three on the other end. Rolls out for Thalheim. Well, they're violating with the rebound. Sides, nope. And a whistle. And we are back in action with 4 minutes left here. And there's another three by Price. Price has had a great state tournament. Here's a turnover. For the moment, Bowman had it. Thalheim knocked it out of bounds, and it will stay with Bucklin. So a good battle early on here in this consolation game. Price feeds it inside. Now the pass. Shot missing. Rebound, no good. Northern Valley has it. And a whistle on 15. Did they get Price for that? Nope. It was on Bowman. Andrew Bowman. That's his first foul. And we have a timeout requested here by Northern Valley head coach Kevin Sides. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. Northern Valley, no stranger to the state championship tournament. This is their ninth appearance. And back-to-back appearances. Last year, they beat Wheatland Grinnell. And then in the state semifinals, they lost to eventual state champion Hanover. 85 to 58. Thank you. Huskies basketball. Nice pass from Sides to Drew Schimpfer. It's 13-9. Here's a deep look off the back of the iron. Rebound chased down by the Red Aces. Price, dribble penetration with the right, and he scores another one. Scott Price, 9 points early on here for the senior. And it's a 6-point Bucklin lead. Schimpfer backs down and misses the shot with the left hand. Price, again, going to the rack and scores it, and one. Scott Price, again, having an excellent tournament. Averaging over 20 points per game through the quarterfinals and the semifinals. He had a game-high 23 against Caldwell on Wednesday. Misses that one. Scored 18 points along with 6 rebounds and 5 assists against Hanover. That included 4 3-pointers yesterday. Thalheim with the deuce for the Huskies. 6-point ball game. Thalheim cuts man off. Pass and the shot by Lindsay. Thalheim brings it up the floor now. Kicks it out to the corner. Pull up on the baseline. Shot's no good, but there is a foul on the play. So Baysides will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Foul is on Price. Hey, the stats they brought me are from last night. We'll hang on to that just in case for reference. Bucklin basketball leading by four, under 2 minutes to go in this first quarter. Colton Stein. Bowman into the lane. Back out to Price, who drives, stops, flips it. Comes up short this time. Jeremiah Hansen brings it up the floor. And he is caught with a little shove. And the ball goes right back to the Red Aces. Colson Cook checking out of the ball game, and he will be replaced by Lucas Kirk, a freshman for Bucklin. Bowman, difficult shot with the left hand falling to the floor, but it goes down. 19-13. Sides, hands it off, and there's going to be a foul on Bucklin. Colton Stein. Hansen gets the ball in, decides, takes a run at it, but misses. 1 minute to go here in the first quarter. Price. Nathan Bowman. Back to Price. Finds a gap. Hits the deck. A whistle. And it's a foul. And that foul was on Loya. And all of a sudden, Loya has three fouls. Three personal fouls on the senior in the first quarter. First shot is in. So Loya will come off, and I think he might have to take a seat for a bit. Kenton Thalheim takes his place. One out of two from the line for Price. It's 20-13. Sides, turns around, pass almost picked off, but pushed out of bounds by Andrew Bowman. Northern Valley basketball, 36 seconds left in this opening frame. And here's another foul. This one is on Price, and that will be his second. All right, so Price will get a little extra time on the bench here to catch his breath before the start of the second quarter. As he comes off. Sides. Bounce pass on along the baseline and the finish by Thalheim. Fine look by Sides. Another assist. Here's a drive, high off the glass. Nope. Rebound. Saved. Ball saved by Stein. There's a stoppage of play. And a foul on Andrew Bowman. 10 seconds left. Sides. Gets across midcourt at 4 seconds. And I don't know if he's aware of the time. Maybe he was. As he turns around, sets a pick or a screen. But Hansen comes up short, and that's the end of the first quarter with Bucklin leading at 20-15 on the NFHS Network. Turn down the what? Is that what he says? I'm a classic rock guy. What? Yeah, in any case, we're here to talk and watch basketball, right? 20-15, Bucklin is led by as many as 8 points in the first quarter. Sides three-pointer, rolls off. Price, Bowman, inside the paint against that zone. Back out. Here's a red ace flashing into the lane and kicking it back out to Bowman. Three's offline. He tries to save it, but he steps on the baseline. A clean first quarter for Bucklin in terms of turnovers. They did not turn the ball over in the first 8 minutes. Northern Valley charged with 6 turnovers. Kalheim. Price with the give to Foster Brands, and it's out of bounds off Bucklin. And Sides grabs the ball and takes 2 steps and scores it rather easily. It's 20-17. Price the other way. Have quite a battle here between 15s. Sides has 8 points for the Huskies. And Price steps to the line, having already scored 12 points in the first quarter. Second one is down, 22-17, 14 points for Scott Price. And a whistle, and a foul on Buckland's Andrew Bowman. And that is his third. So we have one member of each team saddled with 3 personal fouls early in the ball game. Andrew Bowman will get some rest. Little Euro step. And another pair for Sides. Bailey Sides now with 10. 22-19, Bucklin leads. Lindsay made the extra pass outside for the jump shot. And now he's guilty of reaching over the top. He is charged with his first personal foul, and that puts the Huskies in a bonus. So here's Bailey Sides, the senior, averaging 14 a game. He's at 11 already today. And with that free throw, he matches his output in the semifinal loss to Greeley County. He had 12 points and 8 rebounds in the semifinals on Friday. It's 22-21, a 1-point ball game. Drive, and Price tries to throw it over his shoulder. Can't get it to go. Here's a three-pointer. It's good, and it gives Northern Valley the lead. Kenton Thalheim from the corner. Back the other way. It's Price, but no shot. Whistle came before the shot. So let's mark that. That was a big shot. 24-22. Northern Valley regains the lead. This is their second lead of the game. They had an early lead of one in the first quarter. Yeah, some substitutions now. Gabriel Rudd into the ball game, seeing his first action this afternoon. Foster Brand's also back into the ball game for the Huskies. Price with 16 of his team's 24. We're all knotted up. Sides. The drive, the dish, and the bucket, and one. Foster Brands. First two of the afternoon for Brands, who's had a fine state tournament. 3-point play. And the Huskies back on top, 27-24. Here's a three, and we're tied up again on the three-point shot by Colson Cook, the freshman. That shot is short. Rebound, Northern Valley. Another miss. Brands forces one up while he is trying to avoid being stepped on. Had to adjust his eye gear. A three in the corner. This one is too long. Ball out of bounds off of Brands, it looked like, and that's how they judge it anyway. Bounce on the inbounds and right underneath the basket. A great look by Bowman. And the bucket by Lucas Kirk. He found the open spot at the block. It's 29-27. Off the glass. And the first two of the day for Brady Preston. And now we're going back and forth a little bit with Price answering. He has 19. It's 32-29. Bucklin. The three may have been deflected. Price, why not? A little heat check there. I beg your pardon. That was not Price. That was Bowman, the senior Bowman, Nathan. Wide open along the baseline and finishing, Jeremiah Hansen, the sophomore. Quickly the other way, a miss by Price. 32-31, a 1-point lead for Bucklin. Handoff from sides to Hansen, who hits the floor, and a foul on Price. Now Price officially in foul trouble with three. So the hot hand for the Red Aces will take a seat on the bench, possibly for the rest of this half. And Jeremiah Hansen steps to the free throw line, averaging 10 points per game. That one, not quite measured right. Bowman, coast to coast. A little too hard off the glass. Pass up ahead the shot and the foul. Hansen gets hacked as he tries to throw it up off the glass. And the foul's on Colson Cook. So Hansen's back at the line again. That's his third point of the ball game. Hansen had 9 points in the quarterfinal victory over Waverly. And in Friday's loss to Greeley County, 5 points, five rebounds. He hits both. We have another lead change. Bowman drives, turns his back to the basket, lands hard on his backside. He's helped up by his teammates. It looked worse than it felt. But it looked like it felt bad. And it appears from up here that he has... Is that a necklace he's dealing with? Is dude wearing a chain? Yep, he just took it off. Now he is going to... take a seat after that hard fall to the floor. And his brother, Andrew Bowman, will be allowed to take the free throws. He's 1 for 2 at the line. We're tied at 33. Sides quickly up the floor. Runs out of room at the baseline, but he finds an open man in the corner. Three-pointer missing by Preston and a foul. A foul on the Red Aces. And that's another one on Cook. That's his second. So sides. Toes the line. That one is fine. The Huskies back on top by one. He hits them both. Gives his team a 2-point lead. Bowman rounds the corner. That's Kirk. I wonder if they call him Captain Kirk. Probably not yet, because he's just a freshman. And a bucket and one for Nathan Bowman. That ties the game at 35. But he can't complete the three-point play. Second quarter has been a back-and-forth stanza. Sides whips it over. For three from Hansen. Rebound Stein. Stimpert. Stops. Pops. Misses. Rebound pulled down by Schimper. And quickly the other way. It's Hansen with the lay-in. And the Huskies are back on top. 37-35. A 30-second timeout. So in this second quarter alone, Northern Valley took the lead on a three by Thalheim at 24-22. The game was tied. Then Brand with a three-point play put them up by three. It was tied again at 27. Bucklin then went up by 3, 32-29. Northern Valley answered, and with a pair of free throws, took a one-point lead. Game was tied again at 33. Northern Valley with a pair of free throws to go up by 2. Bowman tied the game at 35, and now it's Northern Valley in the lead again at 37-35. A minute and a half left in this second quarter. Bubble with the pass down low. Lindsay had it, and he was fouled, although Foster Brands will disagree. See, held his hands up above his head like, hey, I didn't do anything wrong. And the first shot is in. Brands now with 3 fouls for the Huskies. Jaron Lindsay, a 6'5 junior, good size. Made them both, and we have another tie. Here's a steal by Nathan Bowman. And he crosses over into the lane, but he took an extra step. Bowman's doing the counting in his head, and he believes he only took 2 steps. Sides. Guarded by Kirk. Into the corner. Now back to the corners at sides. Yep. He throws it out to 25. And that is a long deuce. Brody Preston. Out of bounds off the Huskies. It will stay with Bucklin with 35 ticks left before halftime. Kirk, Bowman, back to Bowman for a deep 3 that hit the bottom of the net, and Northern Valley has it with 20 seconds left. Sides, a screen set by Foster, Grant, and the bucket by Sides. He navigates his way to the hoop. Still time for a last shot here for Bucklin, but they run out of time. And we have reached halftime from Barton Community College. When I say back and forth, this second quarter was like a tennis match. And it is 41-37. The Northern Valley Huskies with a 4-point halftime lead on the NFHS Network.
Thank you.
Price gets it back quickly, but he's pushed from behind by Thalheim. After Thalheim missed the three-point attempt. So Thalheim has to take a seat with four personal fouls. Nearly turned over as Brand's got his hand on it. Bowman fakes right, goes left into the lane, flips it up. A nice little lob to his teammate, Jaron Lindsey. 41-39. 4 points for Lindsey. And he'll be back next year for Bucklin, just a junior. And a bad pass by Loya. And another unfortunate pass on the other end by Andrew Bowman. Third turnover against the Red Aces. Bailey sides. Into the corner, now pulls up his dribble. Passes off to Loya. Loya for three, nope. And a whistle. And the foul is on Buckland's Andrew Bowman. And that is his fourth foul. So the fouls here are piling up for a handful of ball players. Bowman checks out. Golden Valley able to avoid the 5 second violation. Can't get the bucket. And then a foul. And it's against Northern Valley's. Is that Hansen? Yeah, Jeremiah Hansen. So he has three. There are four players on the floor with three personal fouls. A wind up for three. Doesn't go down for Stimper. Quickly up the floor. A little Euro step. Nope. Rebound. Loya gathers it. Goes up, scores, and he's fouled. Loya, one of those players playing with three personal fouls. And he has 3 points. Those are his first 3 points of the day. Price out for a wide open look, and it does indeed go down for Garen Stippard, and that ball, I think it touched just about every inch of the rim before it went down, even got a little touch off the backboard. That didn't hit anything but the bottom of the net for Loya, and he has back-to-back three-point plays. And the lead stays at five for Northern Valley. The foul against Northern Valley. I was writing down a stat here. Brody Preston at the free throw line. Jaron Lindsey. Now, Lindsey was in foul trouble against Hanover last night. He fouled out with just 2 points. He has remained qualified for this game with only one personal foul in this one. He has 6 points, and the lead is cut to three, 47-44. Here's a three, an instant three. Loya. He motions toward the Northern Valley student section, who are all holding those pool noodles today. The Red Aces down six, trying to cut it in half, and they do on a three by Price. And Price having a big ball game with 22 points. Sides and Price. Nope, that's Sides and Bowman. And the ball goes to Bucklin with 3:35 to go here in the third quarter. Nathan Bowman. The pass inside, intercepted, popped up, grabbed by Loya. Two steps, crazy curse circus shot, can't finish. Oh, right there on the spot to rebound. With the putback is Drew Shepard, and then he hit the floor. Great work off the glass there by Shepard. And Coach Sides wants to take a 30-second timeout. He's gathered the boys together here and probably check on Shepard after he took that fall. 52-47. So the Huskies have been able to maintain a five-point lead for the most part here in the third quarter. Had a chance to visit with a couple of Northern Valley fans during the time during the halftime break. They enjoyed the central location of this state tournament site. Almena, which is where Northern Valley High School is located, is 150 miles away, about a 2.5-hour drive in Norton County. They're located about 8 miles south of the Nebraska border. Meanwhile, two more for Jaron Lindsay. Cuts the lead to three. Yeah, they're used to having their state tournaments at Fort Hays State, which is fairly close to Northern Valley. They've been to Dodge City for state in the past. This is the second year that 1A Division II has been held outside of Great Bend. Nice pass and another bucket for Jeremiah Hansen. He has eight, and it's a five-point lead again. Lindsay throws it back out to Bowman, who for a moment had it tipped away by Loya. He misses the shot. It's Huskies basketball. 2 minutes to go in the third. These two teams playing for third place in Class 1A Division II. Ball screen for Sides. He flips it over to the corner for three. Hansen fell down. No whistle. Misses the three, but there is a whistle in the other corner. And it's against Bucklin. Colson Cook is out of the game for Bucklin. And Norland Valley keeps it. Sides checking his options here. Turns around to the free throw line. Back out to Hansen for the jumper. Rebound, looked like Price had it, but he didn't. Loya does. Passes it over to Hansen for the bucket. And it's 56-49, a seven-point lead. And a foul on the other end as Lindsay goes up. And he slams into Hansen. And there is another man in foul trouble now. Hansen with four. Lindsay to the corner and an air ball. Bowman, bounce pass, rolls away and a turnover. Loya finally gets a handle, but now he's surrounded. He flips it out, and it's stolen by Lindsay, quickly the other way, turning his back to the basket is Price. That would have been something had he been able to score that bucket. And that is it for Jeremiah Hansen, who fouls out of the ball game with his fifth. So two shots for Price. Price now with 23 points. Make that 24. There's a shot up and in for Skipper. The Skipper. He has six. And yeah, tough break for Lindsay as that one rolls off, but he gets the ball back courtesy of his teammate, and he scores at that time, 58-53. Loya throws it right into the hands of Lindsay. As the clock goes to zero, this will count. Called for the foul. He has four. So Northern Valley has One, two, two guys with four. And they have another who is fouled out, Jeremiah Hansen. Bowman hesitates into the corner. The extra pass for an open three. That was a good look, but he misses it. Colson's Cook unable to cut into this lead, but it is down to four, 60 to 56. And a reach in. And a whistle on Stipper. His first. For Bucklin, Andrew Bowman is playing on four fouls. Sides, cross court, extra pass. Free throw line from the shoulder there. And it's Skipper stepping up here today. And he's into double digits with 10. Price from deep. Skipper with the rebound. But there was a foul on one of his teammates. They whistled. Well, no. There was a foul on Bucklin. The foul was on Lindsay. So here come the Huskies, decked out in all green today. A drive, the pass, hesitation, pump fake, no. Battle for the loose ball. Preston has it. In trouble in the corner. And a timeout call. With 5:33 to go, this is a full timeout with a 6-point game, 62-56, Northern Valley, and we'll just keep it here. Had a chance to look around the rest of the state on the state championship Saturday, and there have been some upsets. It's not all 1 and 2 seeds playing in state championship games. In fact, 2 number one seeds were knocked out in the quarterfinals. In 5A, the Cape of Mount Carmel boys were eliminated by the 8th seed Seaman Vikings. And in 4A boys, the 8th seed Hayden knocked off the top seed Eudora. And then yesterday in the semifinals, 6 more number one seeds were toppled, including the previously undefeated Olathe North girls, the Free State boys, in 4A, the Wellington girls, 3A, the Silver Lake girls, 2A, previously undefeated Valley Falls boys, they lost to the 4 seed St. Mary's, and in 1A Division 1, Hodgman County fell to Pretty Prairie. Pretty Prairie playing for state championship on the girls' side in Class 1A Division 1. We resume action here from Great Bend in our consolation game. Off the fingertips of Skipper. And here comes Bucklin down by 6 with 5 minutes to play. Bowman to the rack and 1. That's Nathan Bowman playing in the last game of his high school basketball career. Has a chance for a 3-point play that would cut this lead in half. And he does. It is 62-59. And Northern Valley will send Foster Brands to the free throw line after that foul by Andrew Bowman, and the sophomore Bowman has been disqualified with his 5th personal foul. Andrew Bowman with a fine performance in the state tournament. 10 points against Caldwell, with 8 rebounds, 18 points, 6 rebounds against Hanover. Today, struggled a little bit with just 3 points. He did have 3 rebounds. And he is out of this game. Darren Stimpert takes his place in the lineup. It's 63-59, a 4-point game. And there's a 3 by the man who just checked in the ball game, Stimpert. And it's a 1-point game, 63-62. And Stimpert on the defensive end. Says, no, not you, not today. No soup for you. Northern Valley basketball thrown way out here to Preston. Now Sides has it. And this shot up and in by Skipper. Skipper has been huge down the stretch for Northern Valley today. He has a dozen. And it's back to a 3-point lead. Lindsey. And he shuffled his feet before he took the shot. Under 4 minutes remaining. Nathan Bowman guarding Sides as he comes down the floor. Loose ball gathered by Thalheim. And underneath the basket, it's Foster Brands, another guy who's come up big. The junior has 6. And give Northern Valley credit for really working the ball outside and in this afternoon. Sides whistle for that foul. Just his second. All right. So Scott Price is up there. Preston checks out of the game as Foster knocks down another free throw. He has 27 points. I beg your pardon. It's Price. He hits them both. 28 points for Scott Price. And the lead is at 67-64 with 3:24 remaining. Let's talk a little bit about Price and the game he's having, the tournament he's having. This kid's been outstanding, finishing up his senior season strong. Game high 23 points against Caldwell in the quarterfinals to go along with 5 rebounds and 5 assists. And then last night, he had 18 points with 6 rebounds and 5 assists in the semifinal loss to Hanover. That included 4 three-pointers. And so far today, with still 3:24 to go, he has 28 points. By far the leading scorer in this state tournament. Thank you, Todd. Todd Moore, the sports information director here at Barton Community College. Price has 3 three-pointers today. He made 4 last night. And he has played every minute so far at this state tournament. Sides gets the ball up the floor with his team up 3. And there's a steal by Price. Swaps it from Sides and lays it in. And it's a 1-point game. And then trouble on the inbounds. And a whistle. And the ball stays on that end of the floor And now Bucklin with a chance to take the lead. Price for the lead. No, but he is fouled. Sides call for the foul. And that puts Scott Price back at the line now with 30 points. He's made the first two. And he's given his Red Aces the lead for the first time since the second quarter. Two out of three from the line. 68-67, Bucklin. Under 3 minutes now left in this consolation game, and it's really been a heck of a game. There's a tendency to kind of poo-poo the consolation game, but in this case, both these teams have played very well today, and this will be a hard-fought third-place finish for one of these squads. A pair of free throws by Kenton Ballheim. And Northern Valley has the lead again by one. And here come the Huskies with the ball. Sides. Boeheim back underneath the sides where he loses the basketball. And now we're back in that back and forth mode in this ball game. Look at this play. Oh, just unable to finish. Sides to, or rather Price to Lindsay, and Cook unable to score it. Here's Thalheim. Bounce pass. Brands hammered, and he'll go to the line. Brands has 6 points today. He is 2 for 3 from the line so far, and he'll get two shots here. Boom. 70-68. Huskies. Red Aces have two men on the floor with four personal fouls. Lindsay and Price. This is the second, so it's 70-68. Lindsay on the baseline. Nice look. Good finish. We're tied at 70. Another tie. Under 2 minutes to play. Here at the home of the Cougars of Barton County. Sides. Ball screen by Brands to the corner. Loya. In and out. And Thalheim tried to crash the boards. Call for over the back. He is not pleased because he has just fouled out of this game with 12 points. So he is the second Husky to foul out of this game. The other was Jeremiah Hansen. And here we are at the free throw line and another lead change. Stimpert makes them both. And it is 72-70 Red Aces. whistle and a foul on Stippert. And that sends Preston to the line, the sophomore. Nope. So a chance there to tie the game up from the free throw line. Passes the Huskies by. It's Bucklin playing with a two-point advantage. Lindsay now dribbling in and pulling up. Stippert back out to Price. Under a minute to go. The Red Aces holding a two-point lead in the final minute. And a foul near midcourt by Loya. And is that it for Loya? Nope, that is four personal fouls. So Price will go to the line to add to his game-high 32 points. Second one is good. So now he has 33. And a quick timeout here. That'll give me a chance to add up the point total for Price as he has put his team up by three with 51 seconds left. Price with 23 points in the quarterfinals, 18 in the semifinals, and so far today, 33, that's 74 points. An average of nearly 25 points per game. For the senior, playing his last game for the Red Aces. The DJ fires up the final countdown, and we are in the final minute of this ball game. Sides. His team down three. Loya for a deep three up top. No. Rebound. Huskies. Sides for three. No, that one's short. And Bucklin has it. Sides calling for a foul. Coach Sides doesn't get it yet. And there he does by his son. So Bailey Sides with a foul to give. Now he has four. So there are three Huskies out there playing on four personal fouls. At the free throw line is the freshman, Colson Cook. And he has 4 points in this third place game. And he's given his Red Aces a 5-point lead with 25 seconds left. Sides for three. Yes! And a timeout. And we are at 17 seconds in a 2-point ball game. Let's check the scoring for Sides. I have him at 19. This game not over yet. Whatever happens here in the final 17 seconds, both these teams should be very proud, especially Bucklin. Bucklin is in the state tournament for the first time since 1994. You know, 1994, that was back like when Forrest Gump came out. 1994, what else was going on that year? Oh, O.J. O.J. murdered his wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and her boyfriend in 1994. Just giving you a little perspective on the last time Bucklin was in the state tournament. And then They won their first ever game in this state tournament when they beat Caldwell in the quarterfinals. I was in college in 1994.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. That could be huge as Bowman on the inbound steps over the line before he passes it. It's a huge turnover. Ball's on the floor. Northern Valley has it down two. Sides with the left hand, and how did that go down? Oh, my. A ridiculous shot by Sides. Ties this game at 75 with 12 seconds to go. Holy cow. Here I'm in the middle of reminiscing about 1994. And Sides is thinking, I got to figure out a way to tie this game up or win it. And you know what? Bucklin gave him the chance. They handed that to him. So you gotta feel for Nathan Bowman for the error he made to give the ball to the Huskies on their baseline. And they do score on the inbounds pass. With 14 seconds left, this game is tied. Wow. So on the floor for Northern Valley is Brands, Skipper, Loya, Sides, and Preston. Bucklin with the basketball. Price, Bowman, six. Price for the win. No, it rolls off, and we're going to overtime. Oh, man. Price had a really good look at the game winner there, but he can't make this shot, man. And this kid has 33 points this afternoon. So we flip the page, and we go to overtime, tied at 75. Might be the highest scoring ball game in this tournament. Bowman. Price. Guarded by Sides. And the charge is Lindsay backs into Brands, who absorbs the contact. Keep in mind, well, I'm just going to say, a lot of guys playing with four fouls, and that is five. On Lindsay, and he is out. And he is replaced by Colton Stein. Jump shot, good! Brody Preston with that jumper. It's a 2-point lead for the Huskies. We get a three here. So Bowman takes it to the rack. Draws contact, misses. Offensive rebound, no good. And are we going to get another over the back on Stein? I believe so. Yeah, that's the second time he's been whistled for that tonight. He's pressing at the line, missing the first. And the sophomore is 0-for-2 at the line. We're in overtime. Here's Price. A little out of control. Battle for the rebound. Skipper hit the deck, and there's a whistle. And that's another foul on Stein, so now he has three. And that's going to send Skipper to the line. Skipper. That's 13 points now. And a three-point lead. It's at 78-75. Here's a three by Price. Battle for the loose ball in the corner. It's on the floor. And they're calling it a jump ball. Possession arrow points towards Bucklin. Nope, my mistake. It's Northern Valley basketball. Pass defense. I could see who knocked it out of bounds because he disappeared down that hallway. And he reappears. And who, of course, it's Price. Kids all over the floor. Now the Huskies get it in, and now we got a 2-on-1. Moya, pass, pump fake, and Prince! Well done. And it's a 5-point lead at 80-75. Price, the dish, and Stein with the bucket. That's the first points of this overtime for the Red Aces. And as they chase that loose ball, Red Aces go out of bounds, and it is Huskies basketball with 1:40 to go. Steal on the inbounds pass is Price. His team down three. Price, little nifty move up top, but he can't finish. He had a great look at it too. Finger roll doesn't go. Now Loya with open court ahead. Pulls up. Bounce pass to Brands. This time Brands misses. Chase for the loose ball. Out of bounds at midcourt. Goes to Bucklin. To 77 as we approach the 1 minute mark in the extra session. Bowman with the bounce pass to Stein. Pass knocked out of there and a whistle blown. Preston whistle for the foul, and that will put Stein at the line to shoot two. He quickly fires up the first one, flips it in. That one missed so badly that it almost looked intentional. The Huskies have it. Loya with the runner. And the blocking foul called. Loya will go to the line. And that is four personal fouls now on Colson Cook, the freshman. Loya, back of the iron, no. He is 1-for-4 from the line tonight. And he makes the second. 81-78. 45 seconds left in the extra session. Will we get a three? Nope, Bowman to the corner. The extra pass. Here's a three, but it is short. That was a challenge three-pointer. Skipper got out there, threw his 6'1 sophomore, threw his hands up in the air and made that a little bit tougher attempt. Brands to the line after the foul with 35 seconds left. And this Brands, again, I've said it a number of times, Brands, Loya, Skipper, they've had some guys step up, particularly Skipper off the bench today, who has 13 points. We have a timeout with 35 seconds left. Preston still has one more free throw upcoming. 82-78 is our score. Kevin Sides, completing his third year, and you know what? His work is really just beginning. He is not a teacher. His main job is a rancher. He's a farmer and rancher. He manages 5,000 acres of cattle. It's a family business up there in the Almena area. And he says as soon as the state tournament's over, he is preparing to have calves. He planned it that way. Second one is flat, and it remains a four-point game with 30 seconds left. Corner, Bowman, three, no! Rattles out of there. Rebound, Huskies, and a whistle. Preston will go to the free throw line after the foul is called on Stein. So, it's all up to the Huskies. They can put this game away from the free throw stripe. And Preston sinks it. Second one, not so much. It's a five-point lead with 20 seconds to go. Price, Bowman, right, left, into the lane. He's going for two. Oh, off the mark. Battle for the loose ball. Right in front of head coach Derek Bevan. And a foul is called against Bucklin. Or rather, no, the foul is called in front of the Bucklin bench. And it's on Loya, who has fouled out of the ball game. And he receives a nice applause. And we'll also get an applause for a young man who doesn't see the floor that often, Jason Cox, who's only a sophomore coming into the game with a mullet, and he's number 22. I bet he wears that mullet for the kids. 83-79. After the miss. Zipper with the foul. And with 9 seconds left, that should do it. As Preston hits the first, and the second looked like it would go, but it didn't. So the clock ticks down. Down by 5 points, an air ball, and the clock will run out. And congratulations to the Northern Valley Huskies on their third place finish in the Kansas Class 1A Division II Basketball State Championship. 84-79. Two teams shake hands, and this was a hotly contested consolation game. As the crew here at Barton brings out the table of medals and a runner and a third place trophy that will belong to the Huskies, who finished the season at 22-3. And if you can stand by for just a moment, we'll give you the final numbers.
And that way you can hug your loved ones and take pictures and any of those things you'd like to do in our secondary facility to the north. And that will allow our fans for the
84
to move into their respective
79. By far the high scoring game in this tournament. So that is the last game for the seniors, who we want to give a shout out to for Northern Valley. This is the last ball game of the high school career for Eric Loya, Bailey Sides, and Aaron Henriksen. For the Bucklin Red Aces, this was the final game for seniors Nathan Bowman, Colton Stein, and Scott Price. Scott Price goes out with a huge ball game. Let's take a look at the final numbers here. First of all, for Bucklin, who finishes with a record of 19-7, Scott Price, 9 of 23 from the field, 3 pointers. He made 3 out of 11, 12 of 16 from the free throw line for a total of 33 points, a game high 33 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists for Scott Price. Three other players in double figures. Jaron Lindsay, 13 points, 6 rebounds. Nathan Bowman, 10 points, 2 rebounds, in a double-double with 10 assists. And Garen Stippert. So four of the five starters for Bucklin reached double figures. Stippert, 10 points, 6 rebounds. For the victorious Northern Valley Huskies, who finished the season with a record of 23-3, all five starters in double figures, led by Bailey Sides playing his final game. 21 points. He has a triple-double, folks, a triple-double. 21 points, 11 assists, 10 rebounds. Wow. 12 points for Kenton Thalheim. And 10 points each for Eric Loya, Jeremiah Hansen, and John Brands. In a game that featured 11 ties and 9 lead changes. And as we leave you on this broadcast, Kevin Sides goes over to get his medal. And the Northern Valley Huskies will each collect their medals and then their third place trophy on their 23-3 finish. For now, I'm going to say goodbye until, but we'll keep the broadcast up throughout the course of this trophy presentation. So you can enjoy that from home if you're watching from Husky Country. And we'll see you next at around a little after 2 o'clock for our next game, the girls' consolation game. I'm Jason Lamb on the NFHS Network.
Thank you.